Very good morning, everyone.
In the last class, we have discussed about Venturi, Orifice, and Rotameter. We have seen what are the limitations of Rotameter, Venturi, and Orifice. And we have also derived the expression for actual flow rate and theoretical flow rate. And we have determined the discharge coefficient for Venturi and Orifice. This thing we have discussed in last class. Today, we will talk about Pascal's law. And we will see what are the what is the fundamental theories of the very famous Pascal's law, because whenever dealing with your fluid, this law comes into the picture. And definitely whenever you are designing any kind of reactor, right? Any kind of reactor. Whenever you are designing any kind of reactor, you, by using this particular theorem, you can determine pressure. Not determine pressure, you can do a lot of you can develop your a lot of correlation based on this theorem. We will discuss all these things. Based on this law is derived, or you can say, the dictated by very famous French mathematician Blaise Pascal. Very good morning, everyone. In the last class, we have discussed about Venturi, Orifice, and Rotameter. In the last class, we also derived the expression for Venturi, Orifice, and Rotameter. We have seen the limitation, advantage, and disadvantage of all flow measuring devices, which is generally frequently applicable in industrial as well as your laboratory scale applications. Okay. So we have seen how we can derive actual discharge and theoretical discharge, and we have also identified what will be the discharge coefficient. Okay, this thing we have discussed, and how we have approached by applying the Bernoulli's theorem. This thing we have discussed. Okay, we have derived the expression as well. Today we will talk about Pascal's law. Whenever you are dealing with any kind of fluid, then this particular law comes into the picture. Okay. We will also see the limitation, advantage, and disadvantage. We will also discuss thoroughly how we can derive the expression for a particular system, or how we can identify the results. Okay. And definitely, whenever you will talk about the designing part of any kind of bioreactor, okay, this is like your CFTR. Okay. When you want to develop your own correlation based on your pressure, you can apply this kind of theorem. If you are dealing with pressure, this is P. Okay. This Pascal's law, it is derived, or you can say, the dictated by very famous French mathematician Blaise Pascal. Okay. According to this theory, let me read a few lines for that theorem. A pressure change at any point in a confined incompressible, now let me highlight few points here, incompressible fluid is transmitted throughout the fluid such that the same change occurs everywhere. Now I have highlighted few lines like incompressible. In the fluid mechanics, we have read, in the fluid mechanics, density should be constant. Okay, density should be constant, so it is called as the incompressible, which cannot be compressed. Incompressible. Okay. Let me read again. A pressure change at any point in a confined incompressible fluid is transmitted throughout the fluid such that the same change, means I'm talking about the change in the pressure, same change occur everywhere. Okay, this thing we have discussed thoroughly, what it is dictating, and what we can interpret this particular theorem. Now this is, assume this is your one cylinder. Okay, you have applied one piston here, this is your piston, and this is completely filled with your fluid. Okay, just see here, this is your fluid. Okay, assume there is some point, there will be some kind of pressure, P1 I am writing, and here some kind of pressure, I am writing P2. If we'll check here, Now you can see here, check here. You are applying some kind of pressure. You can say applied pressure is P. Whenever you will apply pressure by this piston, this is your piston, what will happen? It will go down. It will move in downward direction. Then what will happen here will be, there is a small increase in the pressure will occur. So what will be the pressure after applying the pressure? P, P1 plus P will be there. Okay, P1 plus P. And what about this particular point here? P2 plus P will be there. So what it is dictating, that for the incompressible fluid, now the term, when the density is constant for a particular fluid, is transmitted throughout the fluid, means each and everywhere, such that the same change occur everywhere. Okay. And this thing we have read in 12th standard, like a man can lift a car, something like that. Correct. We have discussed in physics that how a man can lift a car which is heavier than his body. Okay. This thing we have read in 12th standard. So we will see a little bit about that. I am taking small pipe here, and here I am making larger pipe, okay, to make you understand. So talking about the labeling, here there is some kind of fluid label, correct? Here is also fluid label. Okay, this completely whole pipe is filled with fluid. Completely filled with fluid. Okay, this particular portion is completely filled. Here you have applied one piston. This is your piston. Here is one another piston. Okay. And by piston, you are applying some kind of force, P. Oh, sorry. Some kind of force. I'm writing F1. This is your piston. This is your second piston. Okay. You are here. You are applying some kind of force, F1. What will happen? When you apply the force, there will be little displacement in your fluid. Means this particular piston will move up. Let me make it clear again. You are applying here some kind of force, F1, and here, due to applying some kind of force, here will be the moment of the piston with F2, okay, force, okay, due to that applying that force. So what will happen? There will be a small displacement will occur, okay? This particular piston will come down at this particular moment, this area, okay? Means, what does that mean? Means there is the change in the area, and there is a small change in the dimension, in the depth as well, okay? And similarly, what will happen, this particular piston will move up, correct? It will move up with distance, you can assume here d2. This you have taken the d1, okay? And how you will approach, you do one thing. The volume should be constant because there is no leak. Means the volume, how much you have filled this whole pipe, volume will be same. There will be only change in position only. Okay. Now, if you will determine the velocity, volume will be here A1 area. You assume this particular area is A1. And here just assume is area is A2. Then how much will be that volume? A1 D1. And how much will be volume here? V equal to A2 V2, A2 D2, correct? Area multiplied by your, that displaced, you can say the height, or this particular length, okay? Okay, now what we are claiming, there is no leak. So what will happen? The change displacement will be equal. Means A1 D1 is equal to A2 D2, okay? Now, you have got little correlation, this, just make it one. Again, what you will do, you apply the law of conservation of energy, means how much work you did here to displace this much amount of the fluid, volume of the fluid, and how much it work was done by this piston to move upward direction. Okay, matlab means both will be equal, correct? Both will be equal. We are looking for that the displaced volume and here upward volume, this will be the displacement will be equal. Okay, based on that volume, this correlation, and what we are assuming that based on the conservation of energy, that the work done means, let me write here that you have applied some kind of force F1 multiplied by that the displacement. I am talking about the displacement means there is some kind of displacement. It means you did some kind of work. Okay, multiplied by D1 is equal to F2 multiplied by D2. You have got this is second equation. Okay, you have got two equation. Just divide equation. Divide 2 by 1. Do like that. Okay, what you will get? F1 D1 divided by A2 D2 equal to F2 D2 divided by A2. Here will be D1. Okay, sorry. Here will be D2. D1 D1. Let's cancel out. How much it is remaining? F1 by A1, F2 by A2. Now you can see what is the formula of the pressure. Pressure is equal to F by A, force per unit area. Now check, you have got the same formula like P1 is equal to P2. Oh my God, you have proved that pressure exerted by this particular position will be equal to this particular position. And you have proved this thing, P1 is equal to P2. Now, this is the phenomena where you are claiming that a man can lift a car, like if it is you, this is your car, with their body force. Okay, but this is very famous example of hydraulic lift, or you can say the jack, or you can say the hydraulic lift, both of them. Okay, now we have seen that how we can equate the pressures with your body with a particular car. Okay, we have discussed, but one more thing here we have derived, here we have talked about in macroscopic level. There is a two scope, like how we can approach our problem. There is the macroscopic level, this is one, and second is micro, MICRO. Second, micro means it is large and it is here infinitesimally small, very small element, very small, infinitesimally small means you are cutting a small segment and you are making derivation, or you are deriving expression. Okay, we have discussed in microscopic level, and let's see what will happen in microscopic. This particular term, that hydraulic jack, it is macro means large scale. Now you can see how much large, but we are also interested in what will happen in infinitesimally small, that fluid element. Let's have a look. Now let me read for the statement, that Pascal's law states that the intensity, let me highlight, intensity of pressure at any point in the fluid at rest, let me repeat, fluid at rest is the same in all direction. The intensity of the pressure means there is the three-dimensional position, then what will happen, what we are claiming, if the fluid it is at rest, the pressure like Px is equal to Py is equal to Pz. This term we have to prove how we will approach. To approach this particular term, what we'll have to do, we have to assume a fluid element and we have to derive, we have to apply the force balance, and we have to see how we can approach to get Px is equal to Py equal to Pz. First, there is the two assumptions, like we have taken a small arbitrary fluid element wedge shape. Now you can see this is the shape, which is, you can say, the triangular shape of structure. And we have assumed the depth, the width of the fluid. Width of the fluid element ABC perpendicular to the plane is unity. Okay, just keep this in your mind. This thing we have assumed, two assumptions. Okay, now how you will approach here? First, now you can see this much amount of the pressure. If it is your fluid element, this particular fluid element, now this PX, it is exerted in this direction, PX. Then PZ here, it is exerted in this direction, correct? In this direction. And here your PY. And now you can see the distance. Here it is X. This is your X. This is your Y. Okay. And this much you have taken as delta S. Okay, you have got the three length with three pressures, X, Y, and Z. Okay, what you have to do, you have to determine only the forces. Okay, force, how you will approach. There is few line I have written. Let us consider the following term I have mentioned here. The pressure acting in X direction over face AB, like here AB, it is PX, same. The pressure acting in Y direction here will be PY. The pressure acting on Z direction, it is PZ. Okay, then the theta, how much theta we have taken here, angle, it is theta. Okay, theta. And here the fluid element, the length of the fluid element, as I already told, we are talking about infinite space, small fluid element. Okay, so here dx, dy, ds. And density of the fluid, because we have assumed incompressible, incompressible, density is constant. Okay, how you will approach? You have to apply the force balance in each element, in this element, in this element, in this element. How you will apply? How you will apply? Let me write here few lines that okay. Now, here we will derive the expression. How we will approach? Okay, we have to determine first of all the force. P multiplied by A, it is nothing but pressure is equal to force per unit area. That we know, we have seen earlier in that macroscopic level. This thing we know. This is very simple. Okay. Now, we have to determine the forces, and we know the pressure. We have to determine how much is the area. Now just apply this here. How much will be the pressure force? Here will be your Fx. If you will write, it will be Px multiplied by your area. How much is the length here? Now you can see how much is the height, is delta Y, correct? And multiplied by width, how much you have taken, unity. This will be the force. Same thing, just apply here. How much it will be? Fy. How much it will be? Py dx multiplied by 1. Okay, you have got. And one more thing here, you see here in some angle you have applied some kind of force. Okay, then how much will be the angle here? Here will be theta. And if you will determine the component, I think you know this thing. Like if you are applying some kind of pressure or force at an angle, then there will be two bodyguards, like P cos theta and P sine theta. Here will be P sine theta, P Z sine theta. Okay, like your bodyguard. Bodyguard will be always in two directions. Okay, now this term you have got. Okay, first, what you have to do here, you have to also determine how much will be the force. Same thing, how much it will be. This is the component, then FZ will be PZ cos theta ds multiplied by 1. This term
we have got. Okay.
Three term. Now, same thing, each and every term we have written, like you can see the pressure multiplied by the area. Okay. This thing, dx, same thing. We will check P, pressure intensity, or you can say how much pressure you are applying, multiplied by dy into x in the x direction. Now, you can see, same thing. Okay. Same thing we will check for py multiplied by dx1. Py dx1, 1 is your width, and for the z direction, pz cos theta, pz multiplied by dx multiplied by 1. Okay, this much amount force will be there. Okay, one more thing, here we have written force in only in this direction, but here I have bifurcated in vertical and horizontal direction. You can write like that also. Px here, what it will be, means you can directly write fz. I have written in what will be in horizontal direction. Okay, this is your vertical direction. You can directly write here like pz df multiplied by a. I have written in the component. Okay, same thing it is written here, same thing. Now check, same thing. Okay, now we have to determine the weight. What will be the direction of weight? It will be due to the gravitational force. Okay, weight W is equal to mg. Okay, how you will determine m by v, density is equal to m by v, then m is equal to v density and gravitational force. This term you have to use. Okay, because you have to derive your expression based on your known parameters. Sorry, now you see here volume, density, and acceleration. You can say the acceleration due to the gravity. Area, how much will be the area? You have to write the formula for the volume. Area multiplied by width, you know this will be 1. Density rho, g will be your the gravitational force. Sorry, acceleration due to gravity. We are looking for area. What will be the area of triangle? How much it will be? AB multiplied by AC by 2. This is the formula. Okay, area is equal to 1 by 2 base into height. Base into height. Very simple. Now we will check here. How much will be the area? Okay, we have to determine area of the triangle. Now check here. Base into height. Correct. AB multiplied by AC divided by 2. AB multiplied by AC divided by 2. Each and everything it is known to you. AB, how much will be? It will be AB. AB we have already know that, like you should see. AB will be delta Y. How much is the distance, that the length of this fluid element? And delta X, how much will be the length of this particular fluid element AC? We have written this term. Okay. After writing, what is the problem here? We have to determine cos theta and sin theta, because you will get the cos theta sin theta term. Then how you will derive the formula. Okay. Cos theta, we will first of all check the how much will be the cos theta here. Theta it is here. Okay, then how much will be the cos theta? Cos theta will be your AB divided by BC. Okay, then how much will be AB? AB is equal to cos theta multiplied by BC. Okay, how much is AB? AB is your delta Y is equal to cos theta multiplied by BC. BC it is your DS, this length. Okay, DS. Okay, this now same thing you do for the sine theta. Sin theta, how much it will be? AC divided by BC. Then how much will be the AC? AC is delta X. Then delta X is equal to sin theta multiplied by BC. BC is how much? This is delta DS. Now you have got the expression. Okay. sin theta and cos theta. Same thing we have written here. Okay, now we have to do the force balance in x direction and y direction. X direction means in this direction and in the y direction. If you'll check this particular picture, how many type of forces are acting? Like there is a one force here, okay, and there is one another force here, and in the vertical direction there will be this force, it will be in upward direction, okay, and your gravitational force, or you can say the weight of the fluid element, and here will be the one component of your pz sin theta will come from in this direction, from this direction. Okay, now you have to write the force balance. How you will write the force balance? Let me write here. First we will talk about in horizontal direction, or you can say in the x direction. Okay, how you will write? This will be your element, like how much it will be your px delta y multiplied by 1. Okay, and you see the direction, it is in this direction, it is opposite to that. Then here will be minus pz cos theta df multiplied by 1 is equal to 0, means you have to add all the forces and make it 0. Okay. If you will check, you have already derived it, like delta y is equal to cos theta df, or you can put this value directly here. Let me write here delta y is equal to how much is the value that px delta y you have already derived. This means cos theta df minus pz cos theta df is equal to 0. This term cos theta df df will be cancelled out. How much it is remaining? That px is equal to pz. This term you have got. This just make it 1. Same thing you have to do for the vertical direction. How much the vertical direction? 1, 2, 3. Three forces. I think I have written here. Now you can see. Each and everything it is written here. Let me write here. Don't worry. Let me write here. Like py dx multiplied by 1 minus, it will be opposite in direction. Okay, how much will be the fluid element? Like pz sin theta, it is your component multiplied by area, df multiplied by 1 minus your weight. How much is the weight you have determined? Here is the weight, this whole term, dx dy by 2 rho g, dx dy by 2 rho and g is equal to 0. And here you have to assume that fluid element, weight of the fluid element, it is very small, just make it 0, negligible you can say. Okay, what will be the remaining term? Remaining term will be py dx minus pz sin theta df is equal to 0. Let's put the value of this dx. How much is the dx? py sin theta multiplied by df, this is the value of the dx, minus pz sin theta df is equal to 0. Sin theta cancel out, df ds cancel out. How much is it remaining? Delta y equal to pz. Now this term you have got for vertical. Now you can see, if we'll compare equation 1 and 2, if we'll put in the same frame, how much you have got? Like px is equal to py is equal to pz. Oh my god, we have proved that px is equal to py is equal to pz. And for that, very small fluid element. Okay, so you can see how we have derived this particular theorem. Okay, and the whole term it is written here. Now you can see, finally we have got this term, this whole term we were looking for that the pressure intensity will be same in all direction. Whatever fluid element it will take, the pressure intensity will be same in all direction, and we have proved that Px is equal to Py is equal to Pz. Okay, on the next class we will discuss further. Okay, thank you very much.